Good afternoon. My name is Carlo Kert. I'm a professor of care ethics in the Netherlands, Utrecht. And together with Joan, we'd like to inform you about the initiative that we're going to take and going to launch today, aren't we?
Yes.
So who are you?
I'm sorry, I lost my badge. But I'm Joan Trotto. And we're going to talk about an international consortium for care ethics that we are forming. The idea. You know, care ethics has come of age. 30 years, we've done this work, we have an idea of what care ethics means. And the interdisciplinary research that is going on in care is so far-reaching and so global that it's becoming next to impossible for any of us to keep up with it. I mean, there are 25 countries represented here. I was at a conference of 300 international feminist economists who were interested in care on Thursday. In geography, post-colonial studies, in engineering, in anthropology, everywhere you look now, there's work being done on care. And it's so spread out that we figured it's time for us to create some kind of clearinghouse or central location where we can collect all of this work and kind of do some strategizing about how to move forward.
So one of the ideas was to do it very practical and to do it, well, in a sense, perhaps in a charitable way, that we build up from scratch, from what is there already. So the idea is to create an international care consortium, and our university has already some experience with websites. We do have two websites, a Dutch one and an English one. We also have a master in care ethics with each year new students, many things going on, an international book series, and we thought it might be a sustainable environment for this initiative. But it's not an initiative, I think, that is just between Europe and the United States. We'd like to involve people from all continents, and how we're going to do this is still something that we have to find out. But the idea is to make it globally and to make it like a thing that everyone can plug in or connect to who is interested.
So the first thing we decided to do was to create a board of international advisors. We've already asked some people to serve on this board and tried to get people from representatives from around the world. We've asked Vivian Bozalek of South Africa, Daniel Angster, most of you probably know The Heart of Justice, his book. Anne Gallagher has agreed to serve, Maurice Hamilton from the U.S., Han Ki Kim from South Korea, Sandra Logier from the Sorbonne, Helen Colin, who's here, no, yes, there you are, Helen, Tova Pettersen from Norway, and Fiona Robinson from Canada. They're just the ones I could kind of call in a favor and ask people to do something, and so that's the list for now.
So, and the next question, of course, is are there any of other volunteers that want to join the board?
Yes!
All right. Now it feels like we're fundraising. We have one! We need a second!
So how much money would you to buy yourself a new board? No, this is, the idea is really that people would like to participate, would like to come up and lend their name, their networks are welcome to. We will show you how to do this at the end of the show. You can email us. The next idea is to set up a web page. We have already reserved this domain, careethics.org. It has to be technically realized yet, but we have the name, so we can you can write this in your calendars. And I think we should make some starter decisions about what the consumption might do and what not, and this is something that we like to do with the board together as a team.
So, there are many, I think this one's on.
Okay.
Is it? Is this one on?
Yeah.
There are many possibilities. We could continue organizing conferences, and that's not a bad thing. One learns a lot. There's some talk about creating a journal of care. SAGE Sociology now is starting a journal. Of course, there are other journals that have really become places to look for ethics of care materials, nursing ethics, also the journal Ethics and Social Welfare. We have to make some decisions about money. how we would continue to sustain the organization. It might be possible to ask people to donate some membership dues, either individuals or organizations or both. All of these are possibilities.
So our question to you is, what would you like the CARE Consortium to do? And what we ask for is concrete needs, but also broad visions. I mean, I think we need both. And I think these broad visions might also be like things like, where should we be in 5 years? Or what do we hope to achieve in that period of time? Of course, there are some academic concerns. We must have interdisciplinary support, I think, because when it's not interdisciplinary, it will not be fruitful and it will not be giving us anything new. And I think we should look for deeper disciplinary tracks within care ethics, which is also a common thing to, and perhaps even a theme for a next conference in the future. And of course, there are other concerns as well. We've been talking in this conference about politics, about practicing care ethics in different situations, in different fields, media releases, or even aligned with post-2015 development goals, which include unpaid care work. I think there's many that we could develop if we want to.
So, process. Shall we talk for a few minutes about this? Do people want to make a few comments? But if you don't want to make a comment now, you can email us, and we'll collect them and then post the results on the new website. So you can either email me, there's my email address, jctoronto@umn.edu, or Carlo at the University for Humanistic Studies. We expect the new website will be fully operational, go live, maybe sooner, but certainly completely by February or so. So we repeat the questions. First of all, do you think this is a good idea? Second, what would you like us to do? Third, do you want to help? The floor is open.